What is it? Oh my gosh, Resident Evil 3 Remake Edition. Oh my gosh, this game finally came out. And I just want to say one thing about it, like right from the start. I'm going to whisper it though, okay? So I'm not going to yell and freak everyone out.
This game was really, really, it was really freaking awesome.
Resident Evil 3 Remake, right? A game featuring Jill Valentine, again, as a main character. Sadly, that's the last game she was a main character in, and hopefully we get her in another game. But that's beyond the point. The point is, Resident Evil 3 Remake came out almost a year after the Resident Evil 2 Remake, and boy, oh boy, are fans pissed. We're not talking about that. Resident Evil 3 Remake, if you never played the original, is the story of Jill trying to escape Raccoon City. And the thing about this game that I think it absolutely nails is that feeling of escape. In the original Resident Evil 3, you had that, but you had kind of a more slower-paced moments that were peppered in a city filled with puzzles everywhere, because it would make a whole lot of sense that an entire city is filled with puzzles, but, you know, a little jab there at the original. But that being said, I mean, this game was about Jill GTFOing out of the city, and in the original also, it was like, there's an explosion, and Jill's, like, thrown out of her apartment, I guess, and, like, that's it, sort of, for an intro. But this game showcases Jill freaking Valentine's escape, and just how crazy this is that I have to say Resident Evil Remake 3, regardless of what you think of the overall product, probably has one of the coolest intros to a game ever. For the first 20 minutes, solid 20-ish minutes, you were just like, oh my god, Nemesis, stuff happening, explosions, zombies, cars, you'll get it if you've played it. There's just so much. There's just so much going on, and you're just like, wow. 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 It's awesome. It is absolutely awesome. And of course, they're using the same engine they used for Resident Evil 7 and the remake of 2, and it just looks gorgeous. I think it's actually the best looking game that they've used with this engine. I love this engine. The characters look amazingly detailed, along with the environments and the lighting. Ooh, the lighting. The lighting is so good. Hold on, I gotta take a breath. So yes, you play as Jill. You meet with Carlos, just like in the original, and you get chased by Nemesis, just like in the original. Now for me, the core aspects of the original game were about that. Were about Jill's escape. Was about the Nemesis following and chasing and just antagonizing the player, and about meeting Carlos, who in the original was kind of like a little bit aloof and weird, and I mean kind of a goof lovable guy, and this one he's a much more serious, brooding, and downright awesome character. So that was a huge bump in Carlos's pay, apparently. But those were always the core ideas of Resident Evil 3 for me. The city also was a huge aspect. But other than that, it wasn't so much about what Jill experiences in the cities. For me, it was more about just that overall tone and story. So my entire time playing the Resident Evil 3 Remake, I was completely captivated. So much that I almost just didn't want to put the controller down. And I mean, I played this for a good 8.5-9 hours, my first playthrough on hardcore, which I figured I'm a vet of survival horrors, so I should give that a go. And I had a perfect balance of managing my inventory and items and ammo and all that stuff, and still gave me that tension, even though there's a lot more action in this game, much like the original. I felt that that was a very good sweet spot for me. But honestly, going through this game, the pacing is so well done. The next thing you know, the game is over, and you're just like, whoa, did I just beat you? It's one of those games where, like, you kind of look back, and you're like, all right, I finished, and, ooh, wow, that was exciting. And if you dive into it deeply, and you really do a one-by-one comparison of the original and this one, I would say game length, they're kind of fairly similar. But there are things that this game does remove from the equation of the original, and things that it adds on to and extends compared to the original. And I always find that whenever I hear something called remake, and that could be a remake of a game or a remake of a movie, I always feel like the thing that they have to do, ultimately, No matter what, when you make a remake, you have to get the core foundation of the original and keep that. That soft little core of what made that game or what made that feeling of that entry, and put your own spin on it. And so I don't think remakes need to be one for one. I don't think remakes have to have everything from the prior games. That's not how my mind works. And, you know, your mind might work that way. That's fine. And you might be disappointed with this game in that regard. But for me, remakes, I kind of like to let whoever's making them do that and kind of just enjoy the ride of the game. Because when you play a remake, you already know kind of what's going to happen. So there's a sense of deja vu. And in other terms, sometimes in other senses, you get that kind of like, wait, I don't know what's happening now because things have changed in this remake. So that's my personal stance on it. And that being said, I thought this remake was perfectly paced. It was full tilt forward. There was some very minor puzzles, but puzzles that made sense within the context of this being a city and not a city full of weird puzzles, so to speak. And as much as I adore the Resident Evil franchise, 3 always sat funny with me just because it's like you've got this huge city, and I understand. I get it. Like, okay, the mansion was an art mansion in the original, and, you know, lots of booby traps and things and all that. And, you know, okay, cool, got it. And then, okay, 2, it was like an old art museum or something, and the same architect helped make them. All right, cool, but it's like, wait, we're taking this on a global city level? Whoa. Again, it's gamey. I got it. It's a gamey thing. So toning that down to more realistic puzzles and not as many kind of felt okay for me because I just felt like it went along with the pacing. There's never really a dull moment in this game for me. I was just constantly like, okay, next location, the city location, the sewers location. And I loved it. And the slight changes in stuff with Nemesis involving some of his battles, which were completely different. Really enjoyed. And they did turn Nemesis mostly into a set piece driven thing, and you know, by that I don't really have a problem with that either. I felt that Nemesis did usually in the original and in this one instinctive fear and almost adrenaline shot into the arm anytime he appeared, scripted or not. It just Nemesis appears, stars, and I'm like, yeah. So whether it's scripted or not doesn't really bother me either. He did what he's supposed to do, and that's go after Jill Valentine and scare the bejesus out of me when he appears, and he did that quite a few times. I almost pooped. Moving on. I did immediately, and I just want to make this clear, I did immediately go back and play Resident Evil 3 right after the remake just to, you know, take it in again, you know, without the nostalgia on and without the, do I remember this part happening? And there are quite a lot of things that the remake either removed completely or kind of just tinged with a little bit. But again, I don't know. It didn't feel like it bothered me at all. I feel pacing in the original is a little askew and a little slow. And so for me, I felt like the things that they removed and the ways that they tried to move this remake forward just tried to turn it into a better paced, better product is how I looked at it. But again, also one of their own vision. Again, this whole remake thing is, I think you take something that was loved, you take the core idea and you make it your own. And I feel like they nailed that regardless of if they took stuff out, regardless of what they took out. They still nailed it. And as far as replay value goes, this is a whole topic I could get on just a video alone on this topic of replayability. You beat the game, it's done. There is no, like, extra mode, I guess you could say. But there is extra things in the game. Like, there is a shop that opens up that takes the challenges that you can do throughout your campaigns to give you points that you can unlock new weapons that were nowhere in the game at all, and infinite ammo for certain weapons and items that make you stronger and other things like that. You know, so there's varying degrees of these challenges that you can complete in order to unlock these coins or points and then unlock your skills or unlock your items that you get. So, you know, now you can play it again and you can have like a, you know, an ultimate assault rifle with unlimited ammunition. You go in there like Rambo and take them out. And see, that's cool too, because every time you play it, you're just going more towards some of those challenges that involve knocking out, you know, enemies with certain weapon types or amount of enemies. And so that's really cool because everything gets retained in your save file. You know, I just wanted to talk about Resident Evil 3 Remake and get it off my chest. Yeah, I just wanted to, like, vent about it. I want to talk about it. Just SlasherJPC talking about Resident Evil 3 Remake. Did you like it? Did you not like it? Well, you know, tell me something positive. Even if you didn't like it, give me that positivity. I wanna hear it. And until the next video, well, we'll see where it goes, right?